Welcome to Curiously Enough
Halloween Edition.
Halloween episode.
Cool little intro, hopefully. Yep.
We got the core. So we're going to focus on a magician. This is a Halloween episode. It's going to be focused on a certain magician that we think you should know about. But we do want to focus on what we love about magic and the great magicians of the past. And this is someone I introduced him to, of course.
Yes.
And he's probably one of the coolest magicians that ever walked this earth. Before you started magic, before you started to dabble in magic, you thought of a magician. You probably thought of someone who looked like this.
Yeah, a magician looks like Channing Pollock.
Yes, Channing Pollock or Cardini is going to be in your head of what a magician looks like.
He's the most strikingly handsome man.
Strikingly handsome. Strikes you. When you see his face, you're struck. You're like, damn, I don't look that good.
He was billed the most beautiful man in the world.
Yeah, like before People Magazine. Before people had like the most sexiest man alive, Channing Pollock was the most beautiful man alive.
Channing Pollock was born on August 16, 1926.
Here's the crazy thing. Channing Pollock didn't decide he wanted to become a magician till
he was 21 years old.
21 years old. That's okay. He can goof off in high school. At 21, he decided he wanted to be a magician. That's relatively late. Most guys hear about it. I've been doing magic since I was 4.
Channing Pollock is one of the most sophisticated, charismatic practitioners of his kind.
Went and saw a Svengali deck performed for him. And then he's like, that's it. I want to be a magician. How many of you guys have fallen for the Svengali pitch?
Deck. Yep.
The pitch, and it gets you, and you need it. You need it. You need to do it right then and there, and you buy it. And it changed your life. I want to know like the numbers, the statistics for a Svengali deck. After seeing an advertisement in the College of Manual Dexterity, he joined the Chavez School of Magic.
Yes, and he graduated in 1952. And Channing Pollock is most remembered by his great act where he would indelibly produce doves out of thin air.
His dove act is still, like to this day, unparalleled.
Yes.
Like his moves and his technique that we could really get into, but I don't want to spoil it for anybody. But even though if you know what's going on, you're still like, everything is smooth.
And he has a spectacular stage presence.
Absolutely.
It's amazing.
You know what? We should just show him a clip. We're going to show you a clip right now. Here we go.
Sweet. Old world charm at its finest. This gentleman has given up an evening of fun just to take his niece out.
Here.
In London, the smart thing to do after theater is the supper club, and here we have the handsomest man in Europe and elsewhere, and one of the best magicians in the world, Channing Pollock.
Thank you.
The cameras shoot this in slow motion, and yet... And yet...
When Channing first got in Magic, he bought a rabbit and a pigeon. He bought a pigeon. And it's like, man, this pigeon is really big and sucks. So he returned it or ate the cost.
Who knows?
Who knows what he did?
Ate quail.
Pigeon's good. It's like chicken.
Pigeon's good eating. And he got two doves to start his act. He had one thing going for him. He was really, really good looking and really tall.
Yeah.
And his state's present. You're like, you can't teach that. You can't learn that. It's something he was just born with. As soon as he walked into a room, everybody was gonna go like this.
And he had that smile, you know?
Well, only at the end. Only at the end would he smile. Like the whole act, no smiling.
Serious.
No smile, like just like, boom. Like real, just real concentration.
Yeah.
Yeah, just look of concentration when all this stuff was happening. He's like, yeah, I know I'm that cool. On the Ed Sullivan Show about a couple years later. Can you imagine that? He's still fresh, right? Still fresh. He graduates college, the Chavez School of Magic. Then he's on Ed Sullivan. He's touring the nightclub circuit, and he does this for about 10 years, and then he quits. He quits magic. 10 years. He goes, I'm out. Done deal. And you know what he does? Because he's so cool and nobody looks like him?
He acts.
He starts movies. The guy goes into movies because why not? So now you're probably wondering why I haven't heard of Channing Pollock in the movies. And mainly because it was in Europe. So he went to Italy because I guess his looks were international. Posso dare la luce? Tu chi sei? Consuelo Altagrazia. Secondo te chi sono? A giudicare da come sei entrata, dico che sei una donna che mi ama. So he was good looking, not only in America,
international,
but also in Europe.
It's hard to look good in Europe.
Yeah, in both countries.
I could have seen him being a James Bond. I could see it.
I could see James Bond. So James Randi, the famous James Randi, always said that nobody wanted to follow Channing. Like that was like the almost a kiss of death. Like I ain't following that guy. You know, usually when they're on the bill with me, they're like, oh man, can I go before David?
Yeah. Us, not just him. Why am Ferris?
Yes, Ferris. He performed for President Eisenhower, Grace Kelly, when she was a Princess Grace. He was a European actor, and you know what? Let's take a clip. Let's do a clip. Yeah. Clip.
Yeah.
So he does films. So I guess he takes the world by storm from 1952 to 1959. And then he says, you know what, I'm not gonna do magic anymore. And then from 1959 to 1969, he goes, I'm gonna be a movie star and be a leading man. And then in those 10 years, he just quits. He just leaves show business. He conquers the magic world, makes some cool movies. He's like, I'm done. And you know what he does?
He opens an organic farm.
An organic farm. What kind of hippie? He opened an organic farm before organic was cool. In 1969, Channing Pollock just said, you know what?
I'm gonna be a farmer.
I'm gonna be a farmer. How cool is that? How cool is that life? Like, you know, visually, he's like just cool in real life. Like, you know what? I'm gonna be a magician. I'm gonna be an actor.
I'm gonna be a farmer.
Even though Channing Pollock retired, he still remained a mentor and a help to many magicians. In fact, one of my favorite stories was when he gave his act to a chauffeur named
Franklin.
Franklin. And then Franklin called the act
Franklin and the Doves.
Franklin and the Doves. Like a 1970s R&B band. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Franklin and the Doves. That's the coolest name. I wish I could have saw Franklin and the Doves. Man,
when you can find the clip.
We need to find it. You guys need to help me find a clip of Franklin and the Doves. I need to see this. I need this in my life.
In 2000, Channing Pollock said, "The secrets of magic lie in the heart, mind, body, and the soul." Hashtag deep.
Hashtag deep. If you like this segment, if you want to be introduced to magicians that we love to watch, because sometimes we'll just, you know, get onto YouTube and we'll just, I was like, oh, you got to see this guy. Oh, you got to see this guy. It's amazing to experience it, to see it. Because magic to me is best seen live. So
yes.
And even though this is not exactly live, you get just seeing those live performances are just, I'm glad they're documented. Thank you, YouTube, for saving all that
Thank
stuff.
Thank you, YouTube.
We also want to give a shout out to SME Talk Magic. So if you're on
Magic Talk.
Magic Talk?
Talk Magic.
Talk Magic. If you check it out, say hi to Dennis. Yo, Dennis. And check out their page on Facebook. It's on the Facebook.
On the Facebook page.
You can see really good discussions, questions, just thoughts of what we love about magic. And hopefully get it to the art we want it to be. That's it for our Halloween edition. I'm Cameron. This is Ferris.
Hashtag save Ferris.
Curiously enough.
Have a magical life, and I'll see you next time. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do They're watching the clip. They're enjoying the clip.